Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm doing my empties for September. I'm going to show you my pet empties first, then home stuff, and then other stuff. This is, let's get all the cat stuff together. Okay. Pounce tuna, the Meow Mix Ocean Explosion, and their greenies, the catnip flavor. I have three cats, so they go through treats quickly. And then I have another one of these special kitty crunchy and creamy cat treats in the chicken flavor. So now we're gonna move on to Dobby stuff. Went through this Greenies original teeny, because he's, like I said, he's only a chihuahua, so he gets one of those every day, if I remember. Then he currently has these in his cookie jar. These are Evolve Oven Baked Dog Biscuits in the peanut butter and berry flavor latte biscuits. They're shaped like a coffee cup. I got these at Dollar Tree. He likes them all right. Another thing from Dollar Tree I got is Loving Pets Nature's Choice Sweet Potato and Duck Stick Recipe. He really likes these, so when I go back to Dollar Tree, I'll get him another one, but not for a while because he has a lot of treats he needs to go through first. And then these are currently also in his cookie jar. These are the Blue Buffalo Wilderness Trail Treats in the duck recipe. He likes these okay. The only reason I got it because it was on sale, so it was $5.98. So there's that for the animal treats. Hold on a second. Okay, I have this Glade Solid. I think it was in the rain scent. I don't know, the label got pulled off. I have this really old Germex hand sanitizer bottle. We just kept refilling it with a bigger one, so finally the pump broke, so that's gone. Then we have another one. This is the Purell Refreshing Aloe. It's fine, sanitizer. Then I have this Vibrant Life Ultra Strength Baking Soda Litter Box Deodorizer in the fresh scent. This is good. It's $2.98 at Walmart, so I pick it up again. And I have this Love My Carpet and Room Deodorizer in the Fresh Linen. I love this brand, so whatever scent they have available at Dollar Tree, I usually pick up. But it's usually the Fresh Linen or the Tropical one. If I can find it, I get the Excuse My Pet or Pardon My Pet or whatever it's called. Then I have from Dollar Tree, this is the Sure Sense Lavender Automatic Spray Refill. These are really good. Cheap alternative to the name brands, and it works fine. I get it again. I've repurchased it a few times, so. These are good, too. These are the Sure Sense Fresh Linen. It fits the air wick warmers. These are good. They last just as long as the name brand, and they're only a dollar at Dollar Tree. And this one is the Amber Woods scent. Same thing. Then I have one, pardon me. I have one Glade spray in the Peaceful Rose and Wood. It's Rhubarb Rose and Sandalwood. It's the limited edition from Frozen, when they did Frozen line. So it was nice. Don't think I can get it again because it was limited edition. Then I have one Wallflower. This is the Pumpkin Apple. And the notes are Red Apple, Fall Pumpkin, and Ground Cinnamon. This was nice. I have quite a few, so I don't think I'll be purchasing anytime soon. But if it was available, I would repurchase it. And the last, like, Home Goods smell stuff is Super Tarts Wax. This is in... It was called The Red Room. It was based on Fifty Shades of Grey stuff. The notes are peach, cherry blossom, white jasmine, blue sugar, and leather. So. Okay, that's it for the home goods. Let me get into the other stuff. Okay, let's start with like vitamins and stuff. Yeah. I have this Zizol. It's a 24-hour allergy medicine. It's good. I like this. This was all pre-purchased. I just bought that the other day when I went to store. It really helps me. Claritin, or the generic version of it, like the Walmart brand, it's okay. But I like this Zizol better. They say you're supposed to take it at night, but I don't. I just take it first thing in the morning. So, anyway. Then I have the Spring Valley Black Cohosh. It helps with night sweats. So, it's okay. I repurchased it. It's a cheaper alternative to the Estroven, which I was getting. So, it's like a $4 difference. I got this sent to me as a sample. This is the Advanced Orthomolecular Research OrthoSleep pills. They're like vegan. These are gross. I was only able to do like one night because it has two nights worth in there, but the other two were busted, so I'm like, I only had one night's worth to test, and they were okay, I guess, but they're gross. I would never repurchase that. Really nasty taste. Then I got these sent to me through Influencer. This is the Sundown Vitamin D3 Gummies. Supports bone, teeth, and immune health in the strawberry, orange, and lemon flavors. These are good. I get these again. I have to figure out where you get them. I think Walgreens, but you know. They're good. I kept the box for this. This is Genexa Sleepology. It's like a homeopathic sleep aid. It is non-habit forming and melatonin free. What are you doing, milkshake? My cat's being weird. What else is new? Hold on a second. It says flavor with organic vanilla and lavender. These are chewables. They taste pretty good. I didn't taste the lavender. I tasted more vanilla. They're good. I would probably get these again, but if only if they were on sale. Because these are like, I want to say $18. So, yeah. Okay. Then I have this Old Spice Oasis with vanilla notes deodorant. It's good. Men's deodorant works for me. I've tried to do natural deodorants, but they just don't work for me. Men's deodorants do, so I'll just continue doing that. Even though it's not cruelty free, but you gotta do what you gotta do. I don't wanna smell. Then I have this Dove Nourishing Secrets Awakening Ritual with matcha green tea and sakura blossom scent. Hold on a second. Sorry about that. Anyway, I have this Dove Nourishing Secrets Awakening Ritual with matcha green tea and sakura blossom scent. This was nice. I picked this up at Ross for $4.99. If I saw this again over there, I'd pick it up again. It was really nice. I like the scent. Then I have two more sanitizers. I have this one. They're both from Dollar Tree. This one is the cherry blossom scent. It was fine. It did what it's supposed to do. I wouldn't buy it again. This is the cucumber and melon scented one. It was okay. Kind of slimy. I didn't really like it. So, I mean, it did its job, but I wouldn't buy it again. Okay. Hold on a second. Okay. Then I have this Burt's Bees Purely White Fluoride-Free Toothpaste in Zen Peppermint. This was okay. I wouldn't repurchase it again. Wasn't a favorite. Let's do skincare real quick. He's being weird. Milk. There's nothing in the fan stand. Nothing. Weirdo. I have my Alba Botanica pimple patches. They work good. And I also learned that you can actually use these on mosquito bites and it'll draw out all the crap they inject into you to, you know, to make you not feel it when they bite you. So, yeah. Then I have another pack of pimple patches. I think they're from the brand In the Zone or On the Zone. I don't know. I picked up at Marshall's. I don't know how much they cost, but they're okay. I prefer my Alba Botanica better. Hold on a second. Okay, anyway. Then I have this Mara Badescu Buttermilk Moisturizer Sample. This was nice. I think I might get this again. It was lightweight. It wasn't really greasy feeling. It blended in really well with the skin, so I liked that. I don't like really greasy moisturizers. It just, because for me, it just, when I wake up the next morning, it doesn't like absorb into the skin and it feels weird. Like one side of my face is fine. The other side of my face is still like sticky from the moisturizer. But this didn't do that, so I'll probably repurchase that. Then I have this Mara Badescu Botanical Exfoliating Scrub. This was nice. I can't remember if I liked it that much. It wasn't really, I like more of like a gritty feeling, like the Apricot Scrub from the St. Ives brand. This was kind of like really gentle and it was okay, but I like more of a grit feeling. Then I have this Basame Vanishing Cream. It's a moisturizing primer with meadow foam, seed oil, and vitamin A. This was nice, but kind of greasy, so I'm glad I got a sample of it. But these samples are like $4, or at least they were when I first launched. And I had gotten a coupon code to get them for free if I made a purchase. So now when I was looking up the price, now they have it as $0, but you can only get one per order. So anyway, they were $4 when I got these. So. But yeah, the Vanishing Cream was nice but kind of greasy. The Cold Cream, did I like this? It was good. I kind of liked this one. I don't know if I repurchase it, though. I have other cleansers that do the same thing. And this Day Cream. I can't remember if I liked it. I think it was kind of on the greasy side as well. So, I guess it might work better if you have, like, drier skin, because I'm a combination oily, so it just felt greasy to me. So they were nice, but I won't repurchase. Then I used up some lip masks. I had this one. I don't know where it came from. It was fine. This is the Global Beauty Care Collagen Hydrogel Lip Mask. Got this from Dollar Tree. It was fine. I don't think they did anything. Then I got this one from Dollar Tree as well. This is the Spa April Bath and Shower. It's the under eye mask and lip mask duo. They're okay. I wouldn't seek those out either. I used up this Noxzema Classic Clean Deep Cleansing Cream Wash. I always have loved Noxzema. It was good. it's not cruelty free, so I wouldn't get it again, but if I was in a pinch, yeah, I would get it, but I would try not to get it. I would look for something else first. You know what I mean. Then I have this Jeffree Star Velour Lip Scrub in the Blue Raspberry Sucker. This wasn't my favorite. I like his Pancakes one, but I think they're discontinued now. So, Pretties for Your Face has one that's very similar to it, so I buy from her instead. So, I like these, but I think I'll just buy from Pretties for Your Face instead. I have a couple more in my collection of, not this flavor, but different flavors. So, anyway, it was fine. Then I have this Earth to Skin Tea Time Black Tea Night Cream. This was really kind of greasy, so I just kind of used it as like a, I used it on my legs and my feet, so that's how I used that up. Let's get into some bath stuff. Mom used up a Olay bar. She likes those. I'm not a bar soap person. She likes bar soap. I don't. This is the Global Beauty Care Glycolic Acid Cleansing Wipes. These are okay. I have a few more. Trying to stay away from cleansing wipes, but they're all right for a dollar. This is the Cyrus 3 Shower Cap pack. They're all in different colors. I'm like a pink, a blue, and I think there's a zebra one. The zebra one I'm still using currently, but that one's going to go in the trash soon. So that's why I included this little wrapper thing. They're all right. If I'd see them again in Walmart, I'd probably repurchase. Then I have this Daily Concepts Daily Body Scrubber. This one's pretty cool. At first I didn't like it, but after a few uses, I got used to it because the sponge is kind of stiff at first, but after a couple washes, it softened up and it did its thing. So this is pretty good. I'd probably get another one of these if I found it. I don't know where you can get those. Then I have this Parents' Choice Micellar Water Wipes. This baby wipes from Walmart. They're okay. I won't repurchase those again. They were kind of on the dry side. I used up this Bath & Body Works Aromatherapy Sleep Lavender and Vanilla Pillow Mist. This was good. I have bottles and bottles of the lotion in back stock, so... It's one of my favorite scents in their aromatherapy line. Then I have this Dream Pillow Spray. This one has chamomile, spearmint, and lemongrass. I didn't really like this because of the lemongrass. Ugh, it's gross. I know there's a little bit still in here, but it wasn't my favorite lotion. This is the Hemp's Triple Moisture Herbal Whipped Body Cream. It was okay. I wouldn't repurchase. It was fine. Then I have this Pretty as a Peach from Bath & Body Works. This is a shower gel. It says, fresh, juicy, oh so pretty. Life's never been peachier. The notes are blushing peach, jasmine petals, white nectarine, apple blossom, and sheer freesia. This one is really nice. I think I have another one of these somewhere. I love their body wash. I need to find something comparable once I go through all my back stock. That won't be for a while, so. Then I have this Victoria's Secret. They don't even sell body washes like this anymore. They might have a couple different scents, but nothing like this anymore. This is old. This one is Hello Darling. It is white nectarine and peony. Yeah. This was good. I love the scent on this. They don't carry it anymore. Then I have this from Truly. This is Akai Your Boobies Boob Polish. to firm and tighten. Has acai, dragon fruit, retinol, vegan collagen, and antioxidant boost. This is the second one of these that I've had, and I don't know about the firming aspect, but they are soft. I don't know what else to say. It smells good. It has a nice scrub on it. I wouldn't repurchase it, though. I'd rather use the, they have the serums. I think those seem to be helping more than this. So, yeah. Anyway, TMI, I know. But I have some perfumes here. This is the Daisy by Marc Jacobs, Oh So Intense. It says, an intense interpretation of the classic Daisy fragrance. Sparkling bursts of strawberry and pear reveal a sweet honey heart. Soft vanilla, balanced by a crisp green moss, envelops you in a truly unique, addictive blend. Sounds great on paper, but doesn't translate to me. I didn't really care for it, so I wouldn't repurchase that. My friend Lori sent me a bunch of samples of perfumes that I wanted to try, so... this one was Ariana Grande Moonlight, and I have to say I didn't really care for it. I think I have the Body Mist, and I like the Body Mist scent better, which is weird, because this is the Eau de Perfume. I didn't like the Eau de Perfume, but I like the Body Mist. I have Ariana Grande Cloud. Same thing with this. I have the Body Mist. I think I have a small one of the perfume. I didn't like the perfume. No. Nope. I don't know. That just sucks. this one is from the company called Be Layered. This is their Caramel Overdose. A lot of people say that it's strong. For me, I couldn't smell it. I even asked my coworkers if I had put on too much, because I know I spritzed myself down. And they're like, no, we don't smell you. I'm like, okay. So I don't think I'd repurchase this. Because if I can't smell it and my coworkers can't smell it, what's the point of wearing that? And I know you can probably layer it, but I don't like to really layer perfumes. That's not really my thing. So anyway. This is from Notoriously Morbid Cosmetics. This is the Shimmering Body Splash. This is called Later Dudes. I don't know the scent notes on it because it's so old they don't have it on their site anymore. I want to say it's kind of like a coconutty base type of thing, but it's really faint. So anyway, this is my New York DKNY. From Donna Karen. I didn't like this one. I like strong perfumes, but this one was just kind of like grandma vibes, you know what I mean? Kind of really strong. Ugh, I don't like the whole grandma vibe thing. Some people like it, but I like strong perfumes, but that just kind of leans more mature, older woman grandma vibes. Not the pretty flowery grandma vibes. This is strong, like just way too strong. So anyway, I think that's it. Hopefully you guys enjoyed. Give me a thumbs up if you like MT's videos. Subscribe if you have not. We'd love for you to join the fam. And click that bell if you like more notifications from me. And I'll see you guys in my next one. Bye guys.